You weren't two different shoes? One black or one white? What's going on?
I've been in LA and I wear flip-flops there everywhere. But I'd had a couple of drinks before I when I packed.
You mean this
I didn't know
until before you packed to come here.
When I got off the plane, I looked and I'm like, oh, that's embarrassing.
Can we just see what? Sorry, Kate. Can we see what that lady's got in her bag?
She's got something in her bag.
Where?
Oh, some cookies.
They're cookies? Oh, cookies.
If you give them to this gentleman right here, he can give the, them to the panel. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. So now...
Does anybody have a steak or anything?
Next time, bring a steak for Travis.
I mean, the show's pretty graphic and pretty bloody. Does that carry over into the vibe on set, or are you guys able to just, you stab each other and then you laugh it off?
Well, actors are always funny. Suddenly they get a little bit of training and they think they're, they think it's real or they can really fight or whatever. I'm not one of those. I sit back and have a coffee and make jokes with the crew. Yeah, some people, did you see me there? I just got really messed up that dude. I'm like, dude, he's fine. I just saw him walk off.
Do you know how great to fight experience. Like that before?
Oh, they make me look a lot better than I do, mate. Good stunt, guys. Always make you look better than what you are.
You could still take all of us, though, to be honest.
Maybe in a cuddle contest, maybe.
See what they're going to say about you. Is Travis Fimmel
Irish?
Yeah. Close enough.
Got it, okay.
Sorry, I'm not used to dealing with Australians.
I try to sneak in Australia now and then. Whenever I yell, my Australian comes out. Yeah. Shield wall, yeah.
My favorite show in Australia was Skippy. That's about a famous kangaroo in Australia. Live action. Yeah, he's a real kangaroo. He was a bit of a hero. He was, a hero of a kangaroo. He always helped people out, and he was a savior. As a kid, I thought it was pretty cool. Kangaroos just go... That's it, then they jump away. I got a little ranch in Santa Clarita, so you can come up and
So ride. Do you ride, then?
Very badly, do you?
Oh, okay.
How many horses are you keeping?
I only got a couple. Yeah, that's enough responsibility for me.
And is that the type of thing that we're, I mean, do they add a sort of sense of discipline and responsibility to your real life? People say, you always hear this, that a horse girl's a good girl. That you always want to get your daughters involved in a horse.
No, I agree with that. Yeah, horse is good. I think they're great. I got a dog out there too. He doesn't like me though. Seriously, your dog's meant to love you unconditionally.
Right.
He lives with my neighbors.
What is it? What is it about you that the dog doesn't? What do you? Yeah. If the dog could speak to us,
what would he say?
Oh shit.
I love being home. I love working on a farm. That's where I really enjoy.
That's where you grew up on, right?
Land. Yeah.
Yeah. So you have that.
Yeah.
See, so you're totally outdoorsy, and then here you are saying, oh, I hate working out. I like being the sick character who is tended to.
I'm an actor. I'm meant to be dramatic.
Oh.
I'm thinking about you farming, but how do you go from that to being an actor? How did that even factor it?
There's just no money in farming at all. It's more of a passion thing. But
when did you realize you wanted to act? Was there a specific moment in your life?
Hasn't hit me yet.
Were you always creative? I mean, as a kid, were you, did you live in a land of make-believe?
Creative. No, not at all. I never wanted to be an actor, really. I got away with a lot of things because of creative choices, but.
I don't know. I never danced in front of my parents when I was a little kid or sung some song.
You weren't like, Mommy, I'm poor, give me an agent.
Yeah, exactly. You're not listening.
It's Travis Fimmel.
I'm going to get all this right.
Nice. Depends on the day or the night.
There's something between us. It's called chemistry.
It's Travis Fimmel. married. I was wondering about that once too. I was like, really? Flirting like that with me at the bar? And
next question!
You did have a little bit of a romance with one half orc played by Paula Patton. That can't be bad.
Oh, geez. Every day working with her was pretty pretty lucky. Yeah, she does a great job. And there she is. Beautiful. Green.
You don't mind the green? It's okay.
No, I'm into it now. I can't wait for Comic-Con. Yeah, a lot of people do the look early on. I do that like the last day and want to wear the same costume for the whole movie. Always fight with a stylist. It's like, yeah, just let me wear the same stuff.
Did they try to tell you then, no, this takes place a year
later? It's like a Madonna concert. Every 10 minutes you got to change. You should do porn. At least you don't have to change every minute.
Right? It's just now occurring to you.
It'd be a short film.
God, you're such an egomaniac. I can't stand it.
How's my hair?
Which cast member has the best beard? Oh, God. Come on, guys.
Oh, that's the biggest one. the best beards, it's funny because it's how do you answer that? Like, Rollo has, like, one of those.
It's pretty simple answer.
And
now, do you condition it with beard oil? Because it's very soft and supple.
Was it? No, thank you. I like that. No, I shampoo it sometimes, I guess. But yeah, it took a while to grow, you know? I get the homeless thing a lot.
Yeah, so you've been mistaken for homeless before?
Yeah, a lot. I mean, there's one time I was sitting out front of a bank waiting for a mate. I'm just sitting there, I got my flip-flops on and shorts, and a little lady walks out. Little old lady, and she seemed a bit down, so I'm like, g'day, hun, how are you? I'm trying to cheer her up. I get a little smile out of her, so I'm feeling good about myself, you know. She walks about 20 yards past me, then she comes back and she's like, here you go, son. Gives me $1.
$1?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Well, I didn't want to make her feel like she insulted me. And obviously, I don't care. It's free money.
It's great.
Can half orcs take human features? What do you think? Yes. Can orcs and humans mate? We hope so. Can orcs have babies? Definitely. Can orcs breed with elves? Now that.
Who Googles that? What's wrong with you? Who Googled that question? That's just silly.
For Bjorn, I have a question. As your character, do you think you would be strong and adventurous like your father, Ragnar, the most incredible Viking, with strength and vision in the future as the Serpentil?
What can you be more like him?
You're making her blush.
Aww. Oh, little darling, look at you.
So you done?
She made it. Come here, give me a cuddle.
So you done?
Aww.
Yeah.
I kind of think that, like, you get to where you are because of who you are, you know?
Yeah. I think I got to get a lot nicer. Maybe I'll get some big roles or something.
No, you seem pretty nice. No. I mean, you did throw that drink at me back there, but aside from that...
I lit her on fire first.
I want to do real bad things with you.
That's it, then they jump away.